Right morning, you all. How are you all doing? Happy Thursday. This is your girl Shan. Like I always say, I hope you all are doing an amazing, amazing, amazing on this morning. I hope all is well with each and every one of you all. I'm gonna say good morning to the coffee crews that come in. However, today's topic, I will be talking about if you stop trying to change your spouse, if you stop trying to change your spouse, maybe your marriage will be better. Hey, cousin Kim, how are you doing? If you stop trying to change your spouse, maybe your marriage will be better. Let me start off asking this question. And I just love how God allowed me to go through things. And this is going to sound weird. I was just telling my sister this not too long ago. But I love how God allows me to go through things because then that give me something to talk about. If I ain't never went through it, I can't talk about it, right? Hey, Delisha. So I'm going to start off asking this question. Since when do we have the power, or what gives us the right to try to change someone else? That's my question. Since when do we have the power, or what gives us the right to try to change someone else? Now, a lot of resistance that's going on in a lot of people's marriages today. Hey, Natasha. Hey, Ms. Delia. A lot of marriages today. The resistance is 9 times out of 10, your husband or your wife is tired of you trying to change them. Hey, Latanya. And so, in trying to change, a lot of that comes control. I want you to be a certain way. I want you to act a certain way. Why can't you be like this? Now, I'm going to go back to our childhood days. Now, I will say my parents never did this. Hey, Shell, my parents never did this. But, and some of you all may be guilty with this as parents. But have you ever been, hey Kim, have you ever been compared to your brother or your sister growing up to a sibling? Why can't you act more like your brother? Why can't you act more like your sister? You have an attitude. Why couldn't your grades be better like your sister? She over here making straight A's, but you over here failing. Okay, some of y'all probably have done it to your children, and you don't allow them to grow up and just grow into who God has for them to be. Hey Felicia, how you doing, cousin? So that a way they can be nurtured. But I got a question, and I really, really, really want to know y'all thoughts. Since when did we start thinking that we can change people? Hey, Paula, that we can change people. How many of you all, and like I said, don't tell on yourself, just think about this, because remember, I desire for people to think at a deeper level. How many of you all have ever wanted to change your spouse, or you're still in that situation now? You're talking about, I don't know why it's not working. I don't know why they're resistant. Let me give some good old examples because y'all know I will. See, most husbands are quiet. Most of them are reserved. And a lot of that may be just their character. That's just who they are as a person. Most of your husbands used to be outgoing. They would have conversations. You and your husband would have some in-depth conversations. Y'all probably had in-depth conversations when you were dating each other, right? But all of a sudden, over the years, they've gotten quiet. Why is that? And I'm not picking on the ladies, but I know this is primary, customary to the men. However, why is that? Is it that every time they go to speak, you cut them off? And they can't get a word in edgewise. With your communication, wives or women, do you speak to your man or your husband and make it seem like they're dumb? Make it seem like, oh, you can't get you don't know nothing about this situation. Have you ever thought in your mind you want to change him? I'm not gonna lie, y'all know I'm gonna be very transparent. Yes, I wished my husband would have changed in a whole bunch of things, and I was trying to change him. That's why I could talk about this. When we was coming up spiritually in the church, at one of the churches that we went to, I was that wife, I'm gonna be honest, that I wanted my husband to act like Bishop was acting. I'm just gonna be honest. I wanted him to act just like the pastor was acting. I love the way the pastor treated his wife. I love the way the pastor talked about his wife, and things like that, the way he placed her on a pedestal. I wanted my husband to act just like him. Some of us is guilty of that. So much so that to where I was coming back to my husband, and we've talked about this at one point on the radio show. I was coming back to my husband and saying, well, this is what Bishop said a husband's supposed to act like. This is what Bishop said a man's supposed to act like. Da, 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 da. And my husband is real soft-spoken, for anybody who knows him, real sweetheart. And I remember one time he looked at me sideways, like really crazy. I'm just gonna be honest. He looked at me sideways and he was like, so you gonna try to tell me how I need to act according to what another man say? And I was just like, because he never talked like that to me. So I was just like, and he was like, really, that's what you trying to tell me? Now see, I had to check myself. And let me go ahead and give a word of advice. And I was saying this yesterday, and that's why I'm glad. When we start showing love, like the word of God says in the New Testament, I need some of us to jump and swan dive into the New Testament. When we start showing love, good morning, how you doing, Shanette? And we start appreciating our spouse for who they are, then that's when our marriage starts to work at a different level. You see what I'm saying? Now, if it's something that you desire to change in your spouse that is causing harm to your marriage or to your family, I'm gonna need you to pray about it. But that's kind of a different situation if it's causing harm. You know what I'm saying? But if it's allowing your husband or your wife to mature into who God created for them to be, that's a whole different situation. Hey, Cammie, that's a whole different situation. When are we, hey Lisa, when are we going to allow our husbands and our wives to mature in God's timing? But see, what we want to do is we want to change people. Just in life, in everyday life, we want to change people. We want people to be who we want them to be. And a lot of times when somebody come to us talking about change towards us, we got an attitude. Oh, why are you trying to change me? So if you don't like for somebody to change you, if you don't like for somebody to compare you to somebody else, then why do you do it to your spouse and why do you do it to other people? Why are we not operating in God's timing? I know it took me a whole 20 years to mature in my adult years to the individual that I am now, to the wife, to the mother, and as an individual. I could not change the way that people wanted me to change. I tried that. I tried to be what everybody wanted me to be. Have any of y'all ever tried to do that? You tried to be whatever title that everybody wanted you to be, whether it be in the church or out of the church. You tried to be everything that man wanted you to be. And that thing became tiring for me. I was tired. I was tired of fake smiling. I'm not a fake person. I am a loyal person. I don't deal with people who you talking about this person behind their back. And then you turn around in the next breath and you all on social media talking about how much you love them and all this other kind of stuff. I was just talking to my sister friend about this yesterday. I'm not that type of person. So it's hard for me to place myself in the box of someone else. See, we don't like for somebody to do us like that, but we do the exact same thing to our spouse. When we get to the point where we start loving our husbands or our wives, hey, Sister Lolo, we start loving our husbands or our wife the way that God desired for us, because that's what he says in the New Testament. He says love. He says submit. There's a whole bunch of honor, all kind of stuff up in there. But see, we don't do none of that. You see what I'm saying? We're too busy trying to move the way that man tell us that we're supposed to move. We're not doing a Matthew 6 and 33. We ain't seeking God on nothing. We're too busy trying to put ourselves in this box of someone else who they need some work and some change to be done on their own doggone self. You see what I'm saying? Never will I again in my life try to place my husband in the box of someone else so he can act like someone else. Because guess what I've learned? Remember I was talking about yesterday about different stages in your marriage. When you can get to that stage of your marriage where you all lovey-dovey again, you all booed up again, you know what I'm saying? You're enjoying your marriage is when you can look at your husband or your wife and you can love them for who God created them to be. You see what I'm saying? That's when you can start working together on one accord. Because see, this is what we don't understand. When we try to change our husbands and wives to fit some type of facade that we've seen on TV, you want them to be like this reality star on TV. Are you serious? It's not reality, boo. It's fake. So why are you trying to make your spouse be the next Kanye West, the next T.D. Jakes, the next Joel Osteen? You see what I'm saying? Hey, Aisha, how you doing, boo? That's what we want to be married to? A facade? A fake? And then you wonder why your marriage is not working? Stop trying to put people in a box. See, this is something that I've learned. And I know y'all probably like, Shan, really? But follow me on this. This is something that I've learned. When I focus on my own life, When I focus on living the best blessed life that God has for me, when I focus on my own family, when I focus on my own marriage, I don't have time to be worried about what somebody else got going on in theirs. See, people who try to put other people in a box, who try to, let me go ahead and holler at you, Pharisee and Sadducee, let me give you a label, okay? When you try to put somebody else in a box, that means that you not focusing on your own, because people who are focusing on their own don't have time to be focusing on somebody else's stuff. You see what I'm saying? Can I keep it real on today? Now, somebody's gonna get mad. When you have more time that you focus on loving your husband or your beautiful bride, baby, that's when your marriage get better. You see what I'm saying? I ain't got time to be worried about what's going on over here. You know what I'm saying? Even for those who are, you are individuals, you are single right now. Baby, I encourage you to focus on the time that you spend with God. Focus on bettering yourself. When you focus on bettering yourself, you ain't got time for nobody else. When you focus on moving in the things of God, you don't have time. And baby, let me go ahead and tell you from experience, you're not going to move the way that people want you to move when you move in the way that God wants you to move. People going to always be mad at you. So why are you exhausting yourself and wasting your time trying to fit in a box? Why are we doing that? When me and my husband's marriage shifted for the better, it's when I start putting more time into becoming a better wife. When I start putting more time into praying for my husband and covering him in prayer. When I start putting more time in praying over my house. And see, that's the problem why a lot of homes are dysfunctional right now in the world. It's because a lot of people, you're worried about everybody else's situation. You're putting your mouth in on everybody else and what everybody else should do, but you're not taking care of your own. And see, let me go ahead and tell you something else. When you start doing the will of God in your marriage, when you start praying over your spouse, when you start flirting with your husband like I was just doing on this morning. Come on, somebody who flirted with their husband or their wife before they left. Baby, you better get to flirting, because I'm telling you that what you won't do, the devil will. Okay? So flirting with my awesome man of God, for he walked in. Yeah, baby, you sure looking sexy in the past, sir. You know what I'm saying? See, you don't have time to worry about nobody else's. You don't have time to worry about what's going on elsewhere. See, it's those messy people that you don't have your own affairs in order. You're not lining up your marriage according to the word of God, to the scriptures. You're not training up your children according to the scriptures, where you got all this time on your hand to be worried about what everybody else do. You know, like all these people to be sitting up here arguing on social media. That's why on any of our platforms, baby, we not gonna argue. We can have a mature adult conversation where you can share your perspective, but what we're not gonna do is argue. When you have not time to be worried about everyone else, and you're putting all your energy into loving your husband or your wife and not trying to change them according to the world. You see what I'm saying? Because see, let me tell you something that I know that a real wife do. She don't push down her husband. She don't treat that man like dirt. A real wife that is really being a wife according to the scriptures, you lifting your man up. You covering him with prayer. You see what I'm saying? You're speaking life into him, because you recognize as a real wife that the world is beating him up when he go out that door enough. See, a real husband, you're not disrespecting your wife, not your queen. Oh, no, no, no. Not the mother of your children that bore you and that carried on your lineage. No, you're not doing that. You loving that woman of God that God has blessed you with. You are not causing any harm to her. You're not hurting her. You're not talking her down like trash, just like she shouldn't be talking you down like trash. Baby, you are getting into those scriptures and you are living out the word, being the example for your children. That's what you're doing. You know, a real husband. You know what I'm saying? Because you recognize the queen in whom God has blessed you with. So you don't have time to be putting your mouth and trying to compare your wife and make her fit into the form of your mama, your sister, your auntie, or your big mama. Because you recognize as the head of your house and as a man of God according to the scriptures, as you're pouring into your wife and you're speaking life into her and you're encouraging her and you making her feel like she's on the top of the moon. You see what I'm saying? As you're doing that as a man of God, You don't have time for nobody else. You don't have time to be talking down nobody else. You don't have time to be comparing your queen to nobody else, and you don't have time to be changing her. So a lot of reasons why y'all's marriages are not working, if I can keep it real like I always do, is because you're putting more energy into trying to change your spouse into somebody that your imagination want them to be instead of who God has created and designed for them to be. That's why you're at odds. When you start loving your husband and wife the way that God says in the scriptures, baby, I guarantee you and I promise you, you will see that a change is going to come in your marriage and it's going to be sweet. And I can only speak from example. I don't have time to be worried about, in a sense, what everybody else is doing. And if it bothers my spirit that much, I pray about that situation. I cast my cares that I'm worried about on God because he cares for me. That's what scriptures say also. See, I don't feel that there's a lot of people that is out there being real and speaking the truth of what the scriptures say and how we are to apply it to life. And that's why we have so many marriages that are being destroyed. That's exactly why so many marriages are being destroyed. Because see, even in the New Testament, and I'm trying not to preach on today, but I want you to get these scriptures and I want you to apply them to your life, even if you have to go back and research them. That's what I encourage you to do. But see, it says that people are going to be saying things that are going to tickle our ears. They're not going to be telling us the truth in the last days, and we are in those last days. So in those last days, we as husbands and wives don't need to be pushing further apart. We need to be pulling closer together. We need to be even more so one. And we're not doing it because we're worried about everybody else's situation. And we're trying to say that, and a lot of people gonna say, well, I don't try to change my husband. I beg to differ, because I'm sure out of your mouth, you said, well, to your friends, well, I wish he would just provide more for our family. I wish if he would just act like so-and-so's husband, we wouldn't have to deal with this. But baby, there was something in your husband or your wife, for whomever I may be talking to, that you were attracted to, that you fell in love with. What is that? See, you forgot what that is, because your whole mission and life's journey has been to change your husband and wife into who you want them to be by a figment of your imagination instead of loving them the way that God says. See, when I stop trying to change my husband and I start loving my husband, that man started loving me even more unconditionally the way that he did when we first said I do. A lot of y'all ain't felt that in a long time, because when you try to change somebody, let me tell you what happened. Resistance come about, because anybody that try to change me and it's not the will of God, baby, I'm going to resist, revolt, and rebel. You hear me? I'm doing all the reads. You see what I'm saying? Good morning, Shirley. So don't waste your energy and your time in trying to change people. You need to try to change your situation to line up with the way that God desires for it to be, since God is the only one that I know in the history that has created marriage, okay? Quit trying to change and have your marriage look the way that the world says, and try to change and work together to line up so your marriage can look the way that God says. Because when you do that, nobody can't be pulling you on strings. Because see, a lot of y'all right now, I'm telling y'all, y'all can't live y'all best blessed life because you're too busy worrying about everybody else say, and you pulling strings. We need to be able to stand boldly. Baby, when it come to my marriage, I could tell somebody in love. Now, back in the day, I'm going to be real with you. Your girl used to cuss them out. Baby, I had a tongue of fire. You hear me? I would cuss a joker out in a heartbeat, but I thank God for deliverance, and I thank God for change, because I had to change in God's timing. But when somebody says something, if they're giving me good sound advice, now I'm not, you know what I'm saying? Because I have some amazing women, and one of them is on her right now, who has helped my marriage grow to what it was supposed to be. And she was giving me good sound advice. You know what I'm saying? That's a whole different situation. You take the meat and you spit out the bones. You see, you take what applies to you. But a lot of our marriages are failing. So if you get none out of this video today, what I encourage you to do is stop trying to change your spouse. Pray for them instead. Stop trying to, because see, baby, you put more energy in trying to change them. And wives, it's things about you that your husband don't like. You mean. You always got to run your mouth. You don't know how to talk to people. You talk like a viper, but then in the next breath, you spewing out the word of God out your mouth. So you speaking, as my people say from Oklahoma, forked tongues. You speaking with a forked tongue. You speaking out of both sides of your mouth. So he don't like that about you. Sir, Your wife don't like the way that you try to control her because, you know, you want her to change because you want her to act like your mama, your sister, your auntie, your female cousin, and everybody else. Baby, you didn't marry them. You married your wife, and that's why y'all can't grow together because you're too busy trying to change each other. You see what I'm saying? When you start pulling on God in your marriage and you start operating from God in your marriage, then that's when a change is going to come. But when you start trying to, and your mama's in your ear, start talking about, well, if she act like such and such and such, then maybe y'all marriage would be better. Well, look at your mama's situation, bruh. Check out your mama's situation. What does it look like? Is your mama bearing fruit according to the scriptures? Y'all know I said I'm going to keep it real. I'm not trying to talk about nobody's mama. Are you getting good sound advice? You see what I'm saying? Is she, see, this is what I look at. The people who sow into me, baby, I need to see your fruits. You ain't got to tell me, but I need to see it in your actions. I'm the type of person, I got to see what it looked like. I can't just follow anything. You see what I'm saying? If I'm a follower of Christ, I'm a follower of Jesus Christ, his fruits according to the scripture, it led to change. You see what I'm saying? But a lot of y'all following people that don't have no fruits. And then you're comparing your spouse to these individuals and designed for your spouse to change for people who don't have no fruits. Now, people always get into this. Then this is my third closing. Y'all know, you know, pastors, you grew up in a Baptist church. This is my third closing. See, so in my third closing, I'm going to say this. A lot of us follow people who don't have no fruits. People argue with me all the time. I'm not trying to say that a person who's never been through anything can't tell me, because God can, if he can make a rock cry out. You see what I'm saying? But my spirit have to line up with the Holy Spirit. It has to line up with God. How you doing, Brandy? And in my spirit, it's telling me this is what you need to hear. But see, people who are willing to argue, your spirit is not lined up with the Holy Spirit. You see what I'm saying? Or otherwise, you wouldn't even waste your energy in trying to debate. Okay? So, if you're telling me something and God is saying in my spirit, yes, this is what you need to hear, my child. You know that prayer when you was crying out in your closet the other day asking me what to do? Bam, bam, bam. Here's the answer. A lot of y'all are trying to compare your husband and wife with people who don't have no fruits. So in the argument, the people say, what do you mean? If I've never been through anything, I can't tell you. That ain't what I'm saying. But what I'm saying is, for Shan, I need to see your fruits, baby. Or like these kids say today, I need to see receipts. You don't have to produce them, but the way that you carry yourself. You can't call yourself a Christian if the fruit / receipts is not lining up, honey. And I can look straight through people who be faking. It really just irritates my soul. Thank God for the gift of discernment, and it's so strong. And I ain't even got to call you out on it. But it does make me mad when you have people that you're trying to compare your spouse. Either you're going to love them for who God, you know, who you fell in love with and who God created for them to be, so your marriage can mature for the better. Or you're going to go ahead and let them go so they can be with who God really created for them to be. I'm just going to be honest, and it's not you. Stop comparing your spouse to everybody else. You the one married them. You the one picked them. You the one chose them. And like I say all the time, when I'm talking to people, our choices have good and bad consequences. So deal with it. So you can't get mad at everybody for the decision that you chose to jump into, especially when everybody was telling you, even the Lord himself came down and probably touched you in a dream and said, that ain't who you should be married to. But you trying to be hard-headed and prove yourself to people of the world, and you ended up in the situation that you're in. So I said a mouthful on this morning. I hope it blesses somebody on today. Bottom line out of this, quit comparing your spouse to everybody else. Bottom line out of this, quit trying to place your spouse into the box of everybody else in the way that they say that they should be. Bottom line out of this, if you're going through this right now and you're dealing with this issue, I need you to go before God, and you need to pray, and you need to change your heart. Don't try to compare your husband to my husband. Husbands, don't try to compare your wife to my wife. Because one thing that you know about Marriage Mondays with the Kings, me, Chantrell, and Kenya King. Kenya and Chantrell King, because my husband come first. One thing you've heard about us is, in order for us to get to where we are right now, we had to go through some things to get here. We had to struggle. We had to touch the face of God and say, okay, God. And we about gave up many a time, but we didn't. But God, you see what I'm saying? And a lot of y'all are in a place of struggle because you're not willing to get through the struggle. And some of y'all feel comfortable being the victim in your struggle. Oh, yes, you do. Bless your heart. That's what we say in the country. Bless your heart. You love to be in the struggle because it gets you attention as a victim. God just told me to say that. So your marriage will get better when you quit playing the victim, okay? And start doing some work. So you have a blessed day. Don't let anybody steal your joy. Be a blessing to somebody today and not a curse. Share this because it's free, because it ain't going to cost you nothing. And somebody else need to hear this. Quit being selfish, all right? And your girl Shannon be back for you all with whatever God places on my heart. So God bless you and blessings to you.